So, check what I sent you, bro. Okay. We will, Zoop. We will. But I want to go through some of mine first. You've sent me like 40 something, bro. You've sent me like 40 something. And I've, every day for like a while, I was like, hopefully Zoop comes around today. We'll look at some of these. And you never did. So there's so many to look at, but we'll look at them. But I got some that I want to look at too. But yeah, I think it will get put back up on Steam eventually. But I honestly like having the Iron Mace launcher. It's called Blacksmith. You get it from darkanddarker.com. But a lot of people are waiting for the Steam release for sure. But yeah, Zoop, we'll look at your TikToks once we're done looking at some of these. But here, what's the first one?
Look, this is when they expire. Don't forget. Never forget.
Never forget. September 11th.
Hold them up.
Look.
Okay, anyway.
It's common to hear pseudo-archaeologists claim that groups like the ancient Egyptians or the ancient Maya accomplished incredible things. Okay.
So only this, with the help- I don't know. We don't need to get into this. We don't need to watch this whole thing. We'll just watch like the first couple seconds. I didn't even watch the whole thing. I only watched the first little bit. But this is something we talked about a couple weeks ago when we watched that Melody Sheet video where we were like, these ancient alien fucking weirdos out here are always trying to say, oh yeah, a lot of these ancient civilizations, there's no way they could have built this stuff on their own. They needed Western civilization to be able to do that. They had to have had help from aliens, when it's just like literally just a bunch of white people being like, yeah, brown people couldn't have done that on their own. They needed help from more intellectual beings if it wasn't Western civilization. But this is something that very much so reiterates that.
The help of outside groups like aliens or people from Atlantis. What you rarely hear is pseudo-archaeologists claiming that, say, Romans had helped building the Colosseum, or that Greeks had helped building the Parthenon. Why is that? For pseudo-archaeologists, Europeans could have accomplished their feats on their own, but non-Europeans must have had outside guidance. Claims like these are not just outrageous, they are offensive.
Is that a TikToker
here,
or what? What is
and
it?
In so many other instances, pseudo-archaeology sustains myths of white supremacy, disparages non-Europeans, mm-hmm. and discredits their ancestors' achievements. I've spent
okay,
the
I'll
last 12 summers doing archaeological...
Do you have Discord? If you have a Discord, !Discord, join that and post some of those stuff in there.
...fieldwork in the Maya area.
If
Several
not,
years
I'll look
back,
it up.
I was staying in a small village along the Belize-Guatemala border. I spent
we don't need to go into
reason number
17 that anymore.
Why I love men is because they fall for a thirst trap every single time.
No, we
every
don't.
Every single time they're falling for that first... Post a little bikini pic.
No, we don't.
Reason number 17 why I love men is because they fall for a thirst trap
I
every
do
single
not.
Time.
Okay, no, I don't.
Every single time they're falling for that first... Post a little bikini pic. Hey, what are you doing later?
No, Cyber Stephanie
nice pics.
That's
way.
How it happens when we look at Cyber Stephanie photos. No, it's not.
They can't resist it. They cannot
no,
out
it's not.
Run the thirst trap.
No.
They are defeated
She's
every
wrong.
Time, and I love it because they are not even mad about it.
She's wrong.
Girls know that I'm nasty. I sent her back to her boyfriend with my handprint on her ass cheek. City talking, we taking. Girls know that I'm nasty. I sent her back to her boyfriend with my handprint on her ass cheek. City talking, we taking. Girls know that I'm nasty. I sent her back to her boyfriend with my handprint on her ass cheek. City talking, we taking. Girls know that I'm nasty. I sent her back to her boyfriend with my handprint on her ass cheek.
Way too hot.
City talking, we taking. Girls know that I'm nasty.
Jesus
hey guys,
Christ.
I'm in the Amazon rainforest and I just found this gorgeous Peruvian rainbow bull.
No, I did not.
Really?
No, I did not.
This has to be one of the most beautiful snakes
that.
I've ever seen in my life. And she
I
was completely calm.
In my eye, right?
I'm still looking for that 20-foot anaconda.
Oh, you
this
don't
tarantula
check in. Oh,
may
wait,
look
Forrest,
scary,
sorry,
but
you,
he's
you
actually
told
pretty
me to look
nice.
At DMs, right? Are you talking about,
ooh,
look
at this swamp puppy. You sure are cute.
Oh my god.
Yoink. This is a baby smooth-fronted
fuck?
Caiman, and
windless
he looks just like a little dinosaur.
That, is that what you were
Smoky
talking about earlier
frog.
When you said you were
Yoink.
Rich and you looted somebody?
He's
nice,
not happy.
Bro.
This is a bushmaster, one of the most deadly snakes in South America. This is just a baby, but they can get over 10 foot. This cane toad is so dang juicy. Oh my
that
god,
beautiful
so big. Kind
handle.
Of surprised it didn't sting me. My big old hand just confused these ants.
This guy's
ooh.
Fucking crazy, dude.
Yoink.
Guy's insane.
This is a banded calico snake. So pretty.
Get the I
ooh,
I do not want
ant.
Any faucet guy videos
mama
ever again, Andrew. If you send
baby,
me one more
sure
of the yeah
space.
Dog, yeah dog guy, I'm blocking you. Okay? I vibe with him too, but he does some crazy ass shit where he's just like walking a bunch with a bunch of alligators at night. It's crazy.
Hey guys,
can you make a song about my grandma that got shot 3 times in a McDonald's drive-thru?
Aw.
That is one of the saddest things I've ever heard in my life. I got you.
Welcome to McDonald's. What can I get for you?
Fuck that old bitch, man. She wanted that McChicken, but she didn't get her order. All she got was that McBlinkin'. We don't know the shooter, but they hit them shots like Curry. Man, the bullets ate her face like how your granny ate McFlurry.
Grandma!
Can you make a song about my grandma that got shot 3 times in a McDonald's drive-thru?
Grandma!
That is one of the saddest things that...
Grandma! No. No, not you, Grandma. Chill. It's a TikTok. Grandma, go... Grandma, I'm having fun with my friends right now. Please! Leave me alone! I love you. Please. I'm having fun with my friends. Okay. Yeah, dog. No, fuck that guy. I hate him. Zoop, you know who I'm talking about. Yeah, I hate that guy. Bro, you got your Dark and Darker mug? Nice, dude. Nice. Welcome in, man. This right here. This is me when I play, dude. I didn't even see this part. I literally saw the first second of this part and I laughed. And I was like, okay, we gotta look at this. I did not see the second part, bro. But even like a fight or anything like that, when you're PvPing, it's serious, dude. But like when you're just sitting there pickpocketing as a rogue, it's just like fun, dude. The people we used to be. It's even harder to remember. Oh, yeah, when you played Bard, that was literally you. Oh shit, let me get rid of the subs. Okay, so the nothing is in the way of the TikToks. Oh my god,
this one's tough. This is a tough X to make fun of.
Okay, so I'm gonna say something. Shane Gillis, not the biggest fan, but he has some very funny jokes sometimes, but also like has said some problematic things which got him fired from his SNL job. But I've watched some of his comedy recently and he makes me laugh. But I saw he did an interview recently with Sam Hyde, of like a neo-Nazi. And he was like just sitting there in this interview with Sam Hyde being like, oh, bro, I love you. I love your comedy. You're so funny. I look up to you. I like adopt some of your mannerisms. And I was like, it just made me look at him way differently. But I've seen some of this stuff from his recent comedy special, and it was pretty funny.
Just when I'm walking around the apartment all day, just fucking Navy SEALs. They're kind of pussies if you really think about it. You know what I mean? Like using
really
night vision,
try,
sneaking
true.
Up on guys. That's
wait,
a fucking
Troy
coward's way to fight,
no,
dude.
No, I don't know who that is.
You know who's actually brave? Al-Qaeda. That takes courage and bravery. Just in pajamas, throwing rocks at tanks.
Oh, okay.
Heroic shit.
Wait, hold
dude.
On.
Just
what was it?
That's a fucking using night vision, sneaking up on guys. That's a fucking coward's way to fight, dude.
True.
You know who's actually brave? Al-Qaeda. That takes courage and bravery. Just in pajamas, throwing rocks at tanks. Heroic shit, dude. Just
and they won. They literally won. Okay? The dudes in sandals hiding in caves won. Okay.
You and your boys going out in flip-flops. You're all going to get fucked up. No training. Go to his place. We were watching. I don't know if you noticed. The war in the Middle East is just on the internet. The whole fucking thing. Every dude out there on both sides was wearing GoPros the
Sandals
entire time.
Sandals are OP, true.
And you can watch it. We watched like 3 hours of the war in Iraq. And after the first hour, I found myself starting to cheer.
Yeah, guerrilla warfare,
cheer,
the
like,
people, it's very true. Same thing like
I
what happened
like
in Vietnam.
I could relate more to the monkey bars guys. You know what I mean? They were a little more my speed. You ever wondered how you
power.
Would do out there? Watch those guys. Those are just normal fucking dudes. Second shots are fired. There's no game plan. There was no shit. Very relatable.
Dude, that's
guns
not true, though. They fucked us
Gotta
up,
fire
man.
A rocket, it goes straight fucking backwards.
Ooh, welcome back.
They look like
Two
me
long
trying to fire a gun. Their feet move.
We're looking
shoot.
At some TikToks now.
Very relatable. They also never won. They got fucked up.
That's not... See, that's not true, though. Like, they did win. We left, and they won.
Every single time.
So...
Bad. They would blow up, like, one truck every 5 months.
That's not true.
Just as surprised as everybody. Shit finally worked out. You could hear it in their voice. Someone blow up, they'd be like, oh! Hello! It's like, yeah, dude, that's a human reaction. That's relatable. That's what I would do if I saw a fucking explosion. I'd go, oh! That's human. You ever watch Us kill
true,
people?
True, Andrew, true.
I can't relate to that at all. There's some Black Hawk helicopter with night vision, mows down like 40 people. Pilot gets on, he just goes, clear. Just flies away. It's like, yo, that's a psycho. That guy didn't give a
true.
Fuck about that.
True.
At least ISIS is down there having fun, dancing afterwards.
Clear.
You know?
True.
It's like Ewok Village down there, you.
But yeah, like I said, he makes me laugh. He's got some very funny jokes, but man, watching him on the... I saw some clips of him on the Sam Hyde podcast, which, like I said, Sam Hyde is a fucking, like... self-proclaimed neo-Nazi. His show that he had was very much so like a ripoff of the Tim and Eric show that was going to be put on Adult Swim, but it had all these like Nazi dog whistles in it, so they took it down before it even aired, or maybe it aired like a couple episodes, but then it got taken off of Adult Swim. And he was like literally on that dude's podcast fucking being like, I love your comedy, bro, you're so funny, I take some of your mannerisms and I've adopted it into my own comedy. So it just made me look at Shangulis a little differently. But some of these clips are still very funny.
What we need to do now is get focused and stop pointing fingers.
Talking to the squad after we keep dying, this is us in Dark and Darker, 100%.
What we need to do now is get focused and stop pointing fingers. You're a problem. You're a real, real problem.
That's me now that I'm a troubadour, all right? I'm going to be very fucking serious. I'm going to let you guys know when you're letting me down, okay?
What we need to do now
what
is
up,
get focused.
Drew? We're just,
stop
we're
pointing
just looking
fingers.
At some TikToks.
You're a problem. You're a real, real problem.
Okay. Check out this awesome 3D print that I printed. You might be wondering.
That looked like an interesting tool.
Check out this awesome 3D print
that
I printed.
That.
You might be wondering.
Oh.
You better change that fucking design because I want that thing up my ass.
Check out this awesome 3D print that I printed. You might be wondering.
Okay. Heard me going straight to the top. Pretty bitches go tune in. Any flick I wanna drop. Thirsty niggas go zoom in. I can tell she down
bad.
Oh god,
Brian,
get
you
my
can't.
Money.
It's Ice Spice, bro. I gotta work right now.
Man.
I gotta focus.
Look tight, bummy. Baddest bitch he ever met. Damn, it's so nice to meet me. Treat a nigga like my pet. Purred this pretty off Fiji. He love when I get on top. He like my bop. I wanna ride. Man, she don't got my spot. She dumb pop. Shorty is fried.
Oh my God, Jesus
Reason
Christ,
number
bro.
Four why I love men is because you'll be watching a TV show with them, and then every once in a while they'll just be like,
okay, we're skipping.
Being a landlord is not a real job.
True.
Every month feels like I'm getting robbed when I pay my rent.
Not friendly? Ooh, okay.
Being
not even with the proper amount of lubrication?
Every month feels like I'm getting robbed when I pay my rent.
Okay, based.
God damn it.
Mike, not a
this.
Network.
I've talked to you guys before about the perfect bite. This is where I got it from.
Sorry.
This is where I got the perfect bite from. Anytime we've done a cooking stream, last cooking stream, I talked to you guys about the perfect bite.
And what?
The perfect egg.
God damn it.
Mike, not in public.
Sorry. Broke the egg yolk. I almost had it.
And what?
The perfect egg bite.
Enough with the perfect egg bite.
What's the perfect egg bite?
It's everything on your breakfast plate in one perfect bite.
That sounds great. How do you do that?
Well, I could take you through it if you want to see it. All right, well, first you start with a piece of rye toast. It's got to be nice and dense so it can handle all the weight. So you take the toast.
So relatable,
right?
Put
some butter on it. Now, you got to make sure that you don't put too much butter on because it's got to melt into
eggs
the
Benedict.
Toast.
Ooh.
Next thing after that is half a container of purple jelly.
See, I wouldn't put the jelly there.
You mean grape?
Yeah, I guess that's grape. Put that on there really nice. And then here's the Melski secret. Hash browns. It both keeps it separate, yet somehow unifies it into one cohesive structure. After the hash browns, it's time for the ketchup. I put it on in
purple,
a W for wazzup.
Wait,
that's
what?
Right.
What did he say?
After the hash browns, it's time for the ketchup. I put it on in a W for wazzup. That's right. And it's also the most efficient way to distribute the ketchup, so each bite has a little bit of it in it. Now, this is the perfect combination of flavors, but it's incomplete.
Yeah, it's Sandler
for the crown
fan, right?
Jewel. The over easy sunny side up egg.
His daughter.
Put the over easy egg on it so that the yolk is facing the corner. Now, the trick of getting the perfect egg bite is getting all the flavors and the unbroken yolk into your mouth. Because if it's broken, it's ruined. If we've done
it's
our work
ruined.
Properly, we're going to have a pretty good egg bite. I love you, babe. Here we go.
No ketchup for you.
Down.
I like ketchup.
Do
you?
No, don't
but
make
I
this
understand.
Funny, okay? It is serious to him. He is trying.
He's trying.
I need a win.
I need a win.
Things aren't going well for me.
And the guy just gets up and leaves.
Working my life away. I wish I could just stop and go on a cruise.
this is me 5 minutes into the first stream the other day back from being having no internet.
Working my life away. I wish I could just stop and go on a cruise.
No, I had
Oh, you're trying to lock a man down? Okay. Get rid of the thirst traps. Throw up what you made for dinner. Throw up some meals. Start posting your cooking. Start posting you chopping in on that board. Chopping it all up. Start posting
Actually,
red
I think this is honestly, unironically good advice even for dudes. Like,
chicken.
You'll
putting
pull.
It on the stove.
You'll pull. All right.
Post some food that you cooked. Be like, cooked by me, just so they know. Just so it's extra clear for their little heads.
Oh, that
Thirst
sounds
trap
so good,
2.0.
Thrasher.
This is what we're doing in 2023, Ooh. Ladies.
With my baby. I be Bro. In the kitchen cooking pies. I'm like, hey, what's up? Hello. Sit your pretty ass soon as you came in that door. I just want to chill and separate
her. She's like, damn.
Now you take the money, introduce her to my song.
He's like,
my
damn,
baby.
Okay.
I be Bro. In the kitchen cooking pies. I'm like, hey, what's up? Hello.
Learn to cook and touch grass.
Sit your pretty ass.
You know, I don't know about the touching grass part. I don't know about that. Because honestly, Cyber Stephanie raided me the other day, and I'm just, okay, we're not, okay, never. This, I saw this, I listened to this whole one already. This sounds like a really interesting song. I kind of want to go listen to it. The grass is great, okay. All right, let's listen to it then. Let's listen to it. So, okay, let's find it. Rolling. Bushi. But I don't know what song it is, though. Hopefully, can we, okay, we can just click through the songs. But does it say what song it is? It might in the comments. Okay, no, there's no comments. No, it doesn't say. All right, let's just try to find it real quick. Okay, it's probably not this song because I don't think she was wearing that jacket. But she sounds dope. Good for you, Giving Chill. Like I said, post those pictures. You'll pull, bro. Urbanism in America is ruining our lives, yeah. Lack of urbanism, yeah. But no, I want to hear that one song. That guitar riff was really sick.
She's super pretty. She pulling out her titties. Huh? She pumping bottle. She like a weed sticky. She's on my
dick. It might be this song. Yeah, her name's Fushi. Like, we don't have time to listen to the whole set. But I want to listen to that song. It's this one right here. Titties. I heard that too. I was like, oh yes. Oh wait, shit, here, let me remind me if I forget once we go back to TikToks to move my camera back though. So I'm not in the way of the TikToks. NJB, who's that? A math rock riff. I fuck with the auto tune too on her voice. It sounds cool. No, I've never heard of Not Just Bikes before. We'll have to check them out too. Did you answer me earlier and I missed it about Discord? If you have a Discord, post that stuff in there. If not, I'll just try to remember to look it up. Yeah, it's like metal, math rock. Yeah, yeah, okay, cool. Yeah, post anything in there and I'll check it out. TikTok, and I was like, okay, I'm excited to actually check that song out later, and I'm glad we did. Okay, next.
Operation Midnight Climax.
Operation Midnight Climax. I just call that a Saturday night at home alone.
Or this last week of me not having internet access.
Operation Midnight Climax.
Okay. Policeman, Bright Future.
Yo, okay, I watched this one already. I've never heard of this movie called Police Squad. This looks fucking hilarious. Yeah, the depression in his face, right? But look at this, they got the outline in the water.
Something like this happens. I'll walk around the docks, take a snoop.
Yeah!
Lieutenant Drebin, Police Squad.
Oh, I remember you, Drebin. What do you want?
I want to ask you some questions. You familiar with that face?
I don't know. My memory ain't so great.
Oh, yeah? Maybe this'll refresh your memory.
I don't know. It's still kind of hazy.
How about this?
Yeah, I remember him. I used to see him around. Why do you want to know?
I can't tell you that.
Well, maybe this'll help.
You really don't think I should.
Yeah, you still don't think so?
All right, his name is Nordberg. He's a cop.
He was no cop. He was dealing H.
What?
I'm telling you, he was dirty.
Oh, you sniveling scum. I ought to run you in right now.
Nick? All right, all right.
I thought it was Police Squad. That's what people
said. Tried to push something on one of my boys, I swear. So what are you going to do about it, copper?
Why should I tell you?
Maybe this will help.
I still don't think I should tell you.
You spot me at 20? How about now?
All right, I'm going down to Ludwig's office. I'll find out if you're telling the truth.
Oh, OJ's in this? Oh, shit, really? Uh-oh. Oh, wait, fuck, I didn't mean to do that. Okay, here.
Why are you shaking your head, Red Band?
This guy is very fucking funny, too. Along with what I was saying about Shane Gillis earlier, I feel like this Kill Tony podcast, sometimes they have some, like, real, just way too edgy people on here. And even, like, Kill Tony, they say some, like, stuff that's just, like, way too edgy for me. And, like, when I say edgy, I like wholesome edginess. Like, I like edginess, but when it gets into, like, bigotry and racism, it's like, okay, this just isn't funny. But this guy, William Montgomery, is fucking hilarious.
Dumbass, you look dumber than ever over there. Why are you shaking your head, Red Band, you dumbass? You look dumber than ever over there. With your little arms crossed across your giant gut like that, you look like a real dumbass tonight.
No, you be nice to him. Look at him. He has a vitamin...
Red Band, I was kidding.
He has a vitamin D deficiency, William. Be nice to him.
Red Band, I was kidding. Red Band, seriously, I was kidding. Why are you acting sad?
Why don't you guys... Oh, I've never seen Red Band so
sad
before.
Dude, I was kidding! Red Band! Red Band, you know I love you, man. You know I was kidding. Please look at me, Red Band.
Whoa.
Red Band, look at me!
Red Band's eyes are watering right now. They are...
Red Band, I was kidding, dude!
It is incredible.
Yeah, so sad.
Is there a tear? Let me turn your head. Oh my God, wow. There's an actual tear.
Stop!
This is the first time Red Band's ever lost water weight, everybody. It's exciting.
He almost laughed.
This is how Red Band diets. The cryet.
Red Band, I was kidding, dude. Stop.
Red Band is, for those of you just listening to the podcast, for the first time in the show's history, he is legitimate.
Yeah, him, Red Band, and this guy, William Montgomery, they have like this thing where they constantly fight with each other. It's very funny. But this, the dude, William Montgomery's stand-up is actually
Who
really
else got
funny.
That bitch that gets off early for no reason? Y'all could play one game, and they're like,
all right, I'm getting off.
And they always say like they got something better to do. Like, shut the fuck up and get back on. But
literally da bomb in that clip that we watched of Dark and Darker, where he was like, I gotta go after this game. Literally the bomb.
That bitch that gets off early for no reason. Y'all could play one game and they're like,
all right, I'm getting off.
And they always say like they got something better to do. Like, shut the fuck up and get back on. But
science,
who else
got
that bitch that gets off early?
Fucking Christ, sorry. When someone says I listen to everything, what music do you listen to? This is me sometimes. When I'm like, oh, here, you guys want to listen to Lightning Bolt? And you guys are like, what the fuck? Science, I know you're the same. I know you are. Clowncore, yup. I've actually heard Clowncore stuff before.
Beautiful, isn't she?
This kind of I've never seen this show before.
Sure, she needs a little maintenance, but...
This is wild.
With some TLC, little help scrounging a few spare parts, I'll have you to California in no time.
Jackass. Hey. Friend of mine died trying to get to that pile of junk.
You and Doc were friends?
We played cards. Once.
This is war, son.
You do?
We've all lost friends.
Oh, shit, I forgot.
Hell, everybody I ever knew is dead.
Why am I not surprised?
You know, I don't like you.
Well, get in line.
General McCandles, sir, thank you, but I think we'll find alternate transportation.
You think I'm insane, don't you?
Oh, my God, it kind of does look like him.
Well, maybe I am.
It kind of does look like Ice Poseidon.
Too much death. Too many good men
like
sent to an early grave.
Go.
Too many zombies. Stay down, I got this. Come here, you godless creepies! I'll see you in hell!
Look at that. Look at that, dude. Green screen right there.
It's an honest 8 out of 10 with mods.
Though. Okay, we'll skip that. These are my new favorite TikToks. These are my new favorite TikToks. Wait, that's him? That's him from House of 1000 Corpses and Devil's Rejects? Those are two of my favorite movies. I didn't even realize that. Okay. So bad, but so good. Yeah, I would watch it just for effects like that.
Ha ha ha!
multiple times, and every time it makes me fucking laugh. Oh, man. Yeah, it's like a satire. Yeah, that's the vibe I got for it. Yeah, 100%. You in the shower every time? You haven't stretched your voice in a week? Let's go. Here we go. Yes, here we go. I love that song. Okay, no, we just heard that one.
And then FJB, what does that mean?
FJB.
You know what that means.
You know what that means,
Joe Biden,
brother.
You want to air it, you say it. Is it says, we the people, f*** Joe Biden?
That's what it says, if you can read it.
Can you read it? I guess so, but
you can figure it out, right?
So are you part of we the people?
I am part of we the people, yes. I'm an American.
So we the people, f*** Joe Biden.
He's like, fuck.
We the people.
God damn it.
FJB. What does
fuck,
that mean?
I didn't think that one through.
You know what that means.
Didn't think that one through enough.
Joe Biden?
You want to air it? You
damn
say
it.
It says, we the people, f*** Joe Biden. That's what it's.
Okay, anyway.
I didn't even know Mexicans were that smart.
I'll tell you one thing about Mexicans. They're smart enough not to say dumb comments like that and get fired from their job.
Based.
I didn't even know Mexicans
okay,
were
anyway,
that
that's
smart.
Jose the Taco Guy. He's a local dude in Vegas. We watch his food stuff on TikTok all the time. He's great. All
right, whoever was the song quiz gets a... All right, whoever was the song quiz?
I watched this one. I literally did not even like this. I remember watching this and like skipping past it. I did not like that. Okay.
People that move around a lot, bounce their knee.
Okay, next.
I'm a bit of a history buff.
All right, let's see this.
Which, by the way, that is early onset Republican.
Oh, you've actually seen Slayer? That I wish. That would be so... I wish I would have seen them.
I'm a bit of a history buff. Which, by the way, that is early onset Republican. It's a very serious.
Wait, what's capital G?
We the people.
What are we talking about?
People that.
I'm a bit of a history buff. Which, by the way, that is early onset.
Is that the TikTok? All right,
whoever was the song quiz.
People that.
I'm a bit of a history buff.
Oh, the email. Okay.
Which, by the way, that is early onset Republican. It's a very serious warning sign. If you're a white dude in your 20s and 30s and you're like, I can't stop reading about World War II. It's coming, bro.
It's coming.
You might not be Republican right now. You might be young and cool and liberal. Probably think you're safe, dude. You're not. It doesn't happen overnight. It takes time. You think your dad wanted to be Republican? You think he got out of high school and he was like, all right, now it's time to be a prick about everything. No, dude, it takes time.
So you're telling me this is the hood?
Yes, sir.
Like, my customers will feel in danger.
How Popeyes be choosing restaurant locations, okay?
So you're telling me this is the hood?
Yes, sir.
Like, my customers would feel endangered if they came to this location.
Correct.
I'm talking about possible fights. Mm-hmm. Possible shootouts. Mm-hmm. A dice game at any moment.
Yes to all
these.
Amazing.
Let me give you a little rundown.
They definitely can do that, Jupiter, for sure.
Uh-huh. This place actually has the highest crime rate in the whole city.
Uh-huh.
We have an authentic crack house right there with one of its residents.
Amazing. Hey, wait, slow down. We're not the cops, man. Oh.
Look at him go.
Amazing.
You got a nigga being checked right there.
He's talking about this shit.
I mean, anarchists are based, but the tankies, they're just like Twitter anarchists.
Okay, hey.
And a possible shootout that's about to take place right there.
Hey, what's up with you, bro?
What's up with you?
Hey, bro, I got an homie, bro.
Okay, me too, what's up? Right,
they do look like they're
the
about
best
action.
Of all worlds.
Amazing. I thought this location might be perfect, so I went ahead and brought my construction workers just to go ahead and start.
Very resourceful.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
No, y'all stay right there. Y'all got me fucked up. Y'all stay right there, for real. Hey, nigga, you better shut the fuck up talking to me, nigga.
Oh.
I'm not playing. I'm looking for Popeyes, nigga.
Are they with you?
They with me, nigga. Oh. This Popeyes location. Okay. Stop playing with me. Oh,
I love
shit.
Popeyes.
Yes.
Popeyes is great.
Tonight we had an easy crack.
Okay, skip that. Every reason you and me should be alone tonight. Yeah, baby. Tonight. Oh my God. Ice Spice, bro. I can't. I got a reason that you who should take me home tonight. Jesus.
White people used to be cool in America.
Okay.
Long time ago, dude.
I got to go smoke.
The height of white people being...
Hey, that it just comes up in my For You page. What that says about me, you can make a determination on that, all right?
Cool was us going, we're like, man.
How is this?
White people used to be cool in America. Long time ago, dude. The height of white people being cool was us going, we're like, man. That was as cool as we got. We're like, man, see? Man. And then the day white people stopped being cool, it was Jackie Robinson's first game. You can look it up, dude. You can find it. You can find the radio call from that game online. You can hear the exact moment white people stopped being cool. You can hear the announcers. They still got there like, man. Welcome to Chicago, where the White Sox take on the Brooklyn Dodgers. And we all had cool white nicknames. Like, up at the mound is old Curly. He's a 47-year-old alcoholic. He's the greatest athlete alive. Runs a 6-second 40-yard dash. Fastest man alive, they say. Then it happened, dude. And Jackie came up to the plate. You can hear the announcers like, meh. Coming up to the plate is young card boy from Brooklyn. No way he can hit Curly's pitch. Here comes the pitch. Fuck, home run. All right. That was it, dude. Jackie hit the ball so hard he knocked that voice out of all the whites. Not one of us has talked like that since. Dude, one swing of the bat, we're like, meh. All right, yeah, that was pretty good. That was good. It was good. It's time for us to focus on computers.
The scuba den. Cup full of nitro, missing color Tiffany. Mom too small, I think we have an epiphany. If I end up out this clocky, you gon' sing a symphony. Big cup full of nitro, missing color Tiffany. Mom too small, I think we have an epiphany. If I end up out this clocky. Here's how to kill the demon berserker. Okay, we're not
obviously
looking at that.
We're gonna start with a 13-4 time signature.
Mathrock dude joins normal band.
What? And then go okay. Into like a obviously we're gonna start with a 13-4 time signature and then go into
there's an equivalent of this in Starfield. Oh, okay, all right. Oh, is there really? So okay, Bethesda just recycling over and over again. Okay. Alright.
Obviously we're gonna start with a 13-4 time signature and then go into like a 10-6, right? No, it's just gonna be standard 4-4 time. 4-4. I've never heard of that ever. Is that new? What is that? I've never heard of that time signature. How do you not know what 4-4 is? That is like the standard time signature. It's like the OG time signature. That's literally yeah, how obviously. It started. How do you not know?
Okay.
Go up, wait, go up to one. Okay. Oh, you want to see? You're like, I need to know how to kill that thing.
What was
okay,
I thinking? I'll look, we'll look man. At it. I gotta stop drinking. This is just.
So okay, as somebody that. Is a part of the math rock genre, which, like I said, if Giving Tree is still in chat, I'll show you some of my old bands after TikTok. I wrote stuff in different time signatures, different tempos, tempo changes, time signature changes. You never think about it. You're never and people in the math rock genre do not like the term math rock. We just like prog, you know, progressive music. I'm down with Midwest emo. I like that a lot, but. Nobody is sitting there counting it out and being like, all right, I'm gonna write a bar in 5-4 and it's gonna switch to 7-8 after 3 bars. It just happens naturally. Like, nobody is writing it out and doing math. Most of us suck at math. But I said that the other day, and then Sir Mills in the chat made that comment where it was like one lowercase, one capital letter, where he's like, did you know that Tool wrote a song in the Fibonacci sequence? And it's like, okay, there are some bands that do that kind of stuff, you know, where they do plan it out. But for the most part, most math rock bands that you listen to are not planning it out. Yeah, my internet's back. Yep. Oh, wait, are you, Oh, you're on a road trip, Cody? Nice, dude. Yeah, Mills, that was fucking hilarious. Midwest emo it's one of my favorite genres in music, and it's I think a very apt description of the music.
What we need to do now is get
time signatures 32-3. When the boys fumble a group of baddies because of one friend.
Focused. And stop pointing fingers.
Oh, we saw this.
You're a problem.
Okay.
You're a real, real problem. What we need to do now...
Guys, just take after me, all right? If there's some baddies that you want to recognize you, start reacting to their photos on your stream and then post those reactions on their Twitter, and they will not only follow you on Twitter, but then they will follow you on Twitch and they will raid you, like Cyber Stephanie did the other day and a handful of others that have followed me and acknowledged.
I always get folk.
All right, anyway. Brand new bitch, it's a brand new phrase. Chat the other day. Jesus Christ, she's so hot, bro. I can't look at this while I'm streaming. I can't. Jesus, I can't. I'll be so low key. She wanna fly with you, let's make three. I'll be your gold medal. We'll be so hot, I'll be so low key. Surely it's not gonna happen again, right? Fuck! Oh my god. Oh my god, dude. Holy fuck. Yeah, Yaya Maya, aka Six God M. Friend of the show now. She followed us the other day, was hanging out in chat. We did some stretches with her. That was great. Great. Ooh, yeah, Cody. Have a fun road trip though, man. That's gonna be fun at going to the museum, dude. Have fun with that. Bluegrass is like that. People aren't super mathy, but folk origins get some. Oh yeah, dude. Yes. That guitar playing is crazy. Yes, Stretch Club. So yeah, okay. The other day when my internet was out, I was watching one of Maya's TikTok live streams, and she jumped up to like 3,000 viewers like that because she started doing stretches on stream, and. So she came in chat the other day. I told her that I had a gift for her if she ever came in chat, and we gave her a gift. And then I remembered. I was like, oh, shit, we got to do some stretches. So I threw on Pound Town, and we did some stretches. That's going to be up on YouTube in the morning, that whole segment. Did I show her the wall? You guys, were you in here for that, Andrew? I forget who was all in here, but you guys were coming in with the best comments when I was stretching the Giots, the wall POV, that was so good. I just want to be this cool. I want to be as cool as every single one of these. Look at it. Minutes, we're not watching the whole thing. Okay, and Arch, you see, we already reacted to some of her stuff. This is dope. I didn't play South by Southwest 2015, but I was there in like 2011, or it was 2012, 2013, 2014. I went like four different times. I forget exactly what years. Maybe it was only three. But one of the years was I was only there. I was taking my friend's band. I drove them in my van. And then the other 2 years I played with my bands, but I didn't know Caro Benito played at South by Southwest, and this is a dope ass song. Like I said the other day on one of the phone streams, I would choose a house show over playing the House of Blues a million times over. Yeah, that checkered suit though, yeah, styling. Yeah, they were all really cool, way cooler than I could ever be. Caro Benito always had some really, really good video game samples. Yes, Okay, the song's basically that the whole time. Ooh. Oh, yeah, the Mario Kart DS soundtrack, yep. So much nostalgia, yep. This is crazy that this is even a thing, dude. Using a mushroom to generate sounds in your wall rack synth. What are these? It's not a wall rack synth. What are these things called? Those synthesizers? Euro racks. Crazy. Yeah, right? They really are magic, okay? They really are. I've said this before, dude. This Whitaker's documentary, I can't even watch it. It makes me fucking sick to my stomach. But this shit is so funny, dude. My boss showing me 10 more things to do at the end of my 16-hour shift before I go home.
What is it?
Yeah, Euro racks, they're expensive. That's the thing. Yeah, you have to have money for them. They're very expensive. Yeah, so true. Yeah. Mushrooms are fire. I actually haven't taken psychedelic mushrooms since high school.
For the past
been years. Oh, this is Kind Eyes. Kill Murphy, the singer. We've reacted to his band Kind Eyes before. They're so dope. And some of his other music. He's great. Okay, Archis. I wanna sell what you're buying. I wanna stop.
Welcome to Death Tones with my own summer.
Ooh, Death Tones. This is who that band Glare that Zoop showed us reminds me of. Especially his voice. It really reminds me of Chino's voice. The Whitakers, it's a documentary about this extremely inbred family from like Alabama or something like that. Oh, modular synth, that's what they're really called. Yeah, thank you. Ooh, that's kind of it's not exactly, but kind of like what the guitar player for Muse used to do, where he would put like one of those chaos pads and stuff like that into his guitar. That's actually very creative. Yo, okay. I'm going to say this, Science. It depends what era Deftones, because I saw them once where they were all so high, Chino was like laying down singing. And, my two friends who went with me, who were like way bigger Deftones fans than me, it was in a stadium. They were sitting down. I was out on the floor. I went up there. They both fell asleep. It was the worst show I've ever seen. But that was back when they were on hella like drugs. And pretty sure Chino had already passed away or was in his coma. I think so, Cody. I think so. Like I said, I can't even watch it. It fucking grosses me out, the documentary. Ain't compromising, half a million on the coupe. Gang, gang. Drug houses, fam. Looking like Peru. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Graduated crazy. I was overdue. I'ma do pink money, money. Ain't compromising, half a million on the coupe. You told me that you wasn't a freak. Oh my God, Cyrus Stephanie. Now I don't believe you. Cause the way you got me feeling right now, every day, girl, I wanna see you. You told me that you wasn't a freak. Friend of the show, Cyrus Stephanie. Now I can. Okay, skipping that. So. Murphy, the guy that his band Kind Eyes, they're dope. Jupiter, I'm so glad you stuck around so long. You were such an awesome addition to the chat. You were perfect for hanging out around here. Thank you so much for being here. Next time you come around, we'll get into some Dark and Darker earlier, so you can watch like some actual gameplay and stuff like that. We'll be right back. that. Yeah, have a good day at school. See, it was super fun having you here. Passed away. Do you mean Chi from the Deftones? He passed away. The bass player? I'm pretty sure he went into a coma and he never woke up. And I'm pretty sure maybe he's still in the coma. Oh, did I say Chino? I meant to say Chi. My bad. Not Chino. Yeah, Chino's still alive. I meant to say Chi, the bass player. Yeah, anyway. Okay, Archussi. Oh, you know what? I meant to react to this. They have a Lotto and Sexy Red put out a music video. I kind of want to watch that. Here, let's watch that right now. I have it in the watch later list. Oh, did I close the watch later list? I think I did. Hold on. Yeah, Chi. That's what I meant. I didn't mean to say Chino. I meant to say Chi. Not Chino Moreno. But yeah, new music video. Sexy Red and Big Lotto. Watch this real quick. Right here. Oh my god, already, dude. Banger.
Yeah, I sound like your hoe.
Oh my god, can we? I don't know about this.
I get behind your horn, then I be like this. What you doing, Sly? Digging that pussy. Feet it back down.
Here, I know what to do.
What we doing?
Here, you just gotta be ready with it.
In your hoes. Yeah.
Nut in my coochie. Slap on my booty. All in my stomach. Got a bitch running. Hit from the bed, rip on my trash, grip on my booty, you know that it's fat. Whole steady tweaking, little bitch relax. Don't want your nigga, I just wanna crack. Me and Nudie off a perk. He wanna see how this coochie work. Fuck me good, nigga, make me squirt. I'm a irritating, I'm a flirt. Sexy. Take it off when you finna nut. Told him shoot that shit on my butt. He got a bitch, I don't get no fuck. All these niggas belong to us. Raw dog, put it in my guts. Fuck me good, nigga, make me cut. Shoot up the club, make that shit bust like. Dig me down.
Whoa, okay. Okay, now we're done.
Eat me out.
We're not watching this anymore. We're done. We're, I'm gonna review this later. I'm gonna review this music video later. We're not watching that anymore. Okay. We're not watching that. Unpublish the VOD, please.
Anyone who knows even the minimum about communism.
Yo, this kid is very based, and I've literally said exactly what he's about to say. I watched this whole TikTok already, but a lot of people are always out here being like, capitalism's the best, communism is horrible, communism has always failed every time it's ever been applied. That's because it's never been true communism. It's never been like true Karl Marx communism. It's always been communism that was taken over by like an authoritarian dictator who just said they were communist. Like even in China, it's like they're not communist really. Like they have some communist aspects, but they're very heavily capitalist. And they just have a dictator. And like other places that have failed, it's because they had like authoritarian dictators. And sometimes they fail because America forces them to fail through intervention and things like that. But this kid's gonna explain it. So if you never believed me saying it, listen to this, okay?
Knows that
dictator.
It hasn't really worked well for communist countries in the past. Soviet Union failed. China, well, they're not that communist anymore. They're more of state capitalist. All those other communist countries, either they changed their ways or they don't exist anymore. When we think of communism, we think of those states with their human rights violations. You know, the good old stuff.
Communopoly. But, you know, I like, it's funny you say that because I'm not somebody that advocates for any ism, like, fully. I think there's a good mix of all of them that could happen.
If you were able to bring Karl Marx, the guy who invented communism and the Communist Manifesto, and bring them into communist China and see the state of it, they would be like, this is not what I wrote in the manifesto. The point of communism is to make people's lives better. Not to make people's lives worse. And because people, especially in the lower class people, the working class, they need rights. They deserve rights. And they will do anything to get those rights. But that is also a bit of a weakness, because that allows for single people to come up and create dictators.
Bro, those people are so privileged, they have no idea what a fucking tyrant or a dictator even is. Oh my god.
Dictatorships and make everything worse.
Yes, exactly.
For communism, the problem isn't the workers, it isn't the people, it's the dictators. Mm-hmm. That's the problem with those types of countries. It's not the people who fought for communism.
Based.
It's the people who control.
What about skepticism? Like, just being skeptical?
No!
I agree. It's good to be skeptical. Here, we're gonna skip that one. But dude, listen to this. And this is... Would I like this? I liked it for 4th, because that day where we listened to, like, old Pierce the Veil stuff. Listen to these fucking kids. These fucking young shredders, dude. Or Rizism. I mean... Rizism you learn from watching this stream. And I'm gonna be... I'm not even kidding, okay? Just based off of the last desktop stream on Wednesday, it was proven that I am the master of Rizonomics and Rizonometry, and if you want to learn, you come to me, okay? There's a reason why we got the raids and the follows that we did the other day. All right, guys? Just moving on.
Off the surf! To jump off the surfing bridge!
Never in a afraid! I'm like that!
Yep, yep, let's raise our hands!
Take a look up in the
sky and I see red!
Rap for the cancer,
rap for the wealthy, rap for the dream that
sets us to a sign!
Everything moves!
Please won't you push me for the last time? My scream is there's nothing left! So sick of playing, I don't want this anymore! The thought of you is not very kind, you wanna murder, I'll be fine! Yes, and I've seen nothing, we're done!
Bro, I hope these kids are like, it's 10 years old. I hope they're fucking in dope ass bands now. Oh, POV, everything's been annoying you all day and it's the final straw. True. Hypermetabolism. Yep, true, based. He is really based, that kid. He is very based. He has some unbased TikToks too, but he's a very smart little kid. Yeah, would you have? They're asking, nice. That's how you were your gas station job. I think we've all been here before.
I think we've all been there. The gay or the army, the scarier.
Okay, what's what?
The gay or the army, the scarier.
Okay.
Forever, dude, throughout history. Think of any army throughout history. Imagine them gay. Gay Nazis?
I mean, Hitler, a lot of people think he was gay.
Just when you thought those guys couldn't look any sharper.
And he had a lot of internal self-hate, and that was partly why he took it out on other people.
Gay Vikings? Gay Vikings, dude. You're just some villager looking out on the shoreline, see a bunch of Viking longships coming. You're like, oh no, it's the Vikings. They're gonna rape our wives and daughters. Then they pull up their fucking rainbow flag on their boat and you're just like,
Oh fuck.
Oh, that's way worse.
They're gay coming or the army, guys. That's pretty funny. Oh man. Oh dude. See, jokes like that can be funny when the butt of the joke isn't like, oh, gay people, it's weird. You know, it's like that's like a part of like the experience. Like that shit's fucking hilarious right there. Did he really? I didn't know that. But that day when we were playing Dark and Darker and you made that comment about the bomb's kids, about how they were like putting the strawberries on the carpet and you were like, you should let them do free art expression, because remember what happened last time? There was a failed artist, remember? That was fucking hilarious. Me patiently waiting for my pretty girl to text me back whenever she's busy. I don't remember this at all.
She looks just like a tree.
I don't don't remember liking this at all. I don't even remember seeing this. What happened last time? Well, so Hitler was a failed artist. It just like I've talked about this before, most conservatives, Ben Shapiro, Steven Crowder, Jordan Peterson, they're all like failed artists, whether it's musicians, actors, screenwriters. They all were like a part of liberal arts spaces, but they were kicked out because they like had horrible ideology. And Hitler was like a failed artist who was like kicked out of like art programs and things like that. And then he ended up genociding people.
That's the thing about these countries. I was just in England, Scotland, Ireland, Australia. No black people. And I know what you're thinking. No.
Okay, no.
No, you need black people. You need black people to keep the whites in check.
Okay, good.
The last thing you want is a whole island of whites that think they're the coolest people on earth. It's a disaster. That's how you end up with Conor McGregor's walking around like, ah, da 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 da. It's like, shut up, dude. The foreign whites are out of control. American whites, we're humble.
Nah, I don't know about that.
We know we're not the coolest guys around.
Not all of them.
It's the foreign whites, dude. Is there, yeah, yes! Preach, brother! Yeah. For real, though, there's a reason every good NBA player that's white is from another country. The audacity to think you could play in that league, dude. The fucking arrogance. Every white dude in America saw a black kid dunk in like eighth grade and was just like, oh, all right. There goes that dream. I'll just set picks for the next 4 years. Just box out hard as hell.
No one texts me, but as soon as I'm about to jack off, people want to interrupt. Literally, this happened the other day to me. Right? Happened to me the other fucking day, and it was from 4th. Okay, anyway, moving on. Oh yeah, I never knew that, Thrasher. I never even heard about that. When that 1,000 milligram edible kicks in when you're on the clock, yup. I hope this guy falls over on live TV and fucking cracks his head open. Oh, here we are at the local Palo Alto yearly wine and yacht festival. This dad has benefited from so much intergenerational wealth. It literally says on the stage, Boatyard, Wicked Weed Brewing. That's literally what it is. This is literally the yearly festival up in Palo Alto where all the rich people get together.
You said the crime rate is high around here?
You're watching Korn, and they start playing music like, I'm trying to bust a nut, not bust a move. Yo, this is exactly what Jupiter was talking about a minute ago. Shredders, dude. Just straight shredders. Grass, dude, just country shit like this. This is the good country, you know. Not that country like that. What's that one song? The red haired dude with the beard, that got like really popular recently. Oh, dude, shredding on upright bass, dude. That shit's tight. You know what song I'm talking about? That do you even brought it up, Science? What was that guy? What was it? Something north of Ridgeman or no? What was it called? North of something. That song could have been good, man. But he just had that one part in the song that was all like hating on welfare and it was like, bro, what are you? This is no, and hating on taxes. And it was like, bro, come on, you almost had it, dude. And then all the Republicans just ran with it.
I have youth spies that I give poppers to that tell me about new music.
Ridgeman, north of Ridgeman. Yeah. That's it. There was so much bass stuff in that song, but then there was those like couple parts that were like,
"Corn," because I can't go to a rap club.
Pornhub is a real website. And it lists different types of corn. Wait,
at 3.
Okay, what
I
is
have
this?
Youth spies that I give poppers to that tell me about new music as a reward.
Okay.
Because I can't go to a rap club at 3 a.m., but I like to know about them. And whenever you say, oh, they don't have music as good as when I'm young, that means your life is over and you're an old fart and you have no influence on anybody anymore.
True. That you always got to keep your ear to the ground when it comes to music. Of course, there's going to be things you don't like, but the moment you're like, it's never been as good as the classic rock days, it's like, okay.
So you should
to me, I'm always way more about contemporary about music than like older shit.
I have youth spies that I give poppers.
I'm sorry. Pornhub is down? No! Friggin' Archosy once again, dude. Legend. Okay, anyway. Bro, this one right here, dude. Commented this, I was like, I always thought Kurt was the best Dance Gavin dancer, but I think they should get this guy now. Put on a show. Oh, you have to type website instead. Oh, okay. Go. Oh, that was the Lexi post. Okay, we looked at all these. Yo, this band right here, this is one of like the greatest metal bands of all time, especially because of the singer, Mitch Lurker. He passed away in a motorcycle accident. He was driving way too crazy and fast. But he has one of the, like, just like Brian or Trevor from the Black Dahlia Murder, one of the most iconic metal voices of all time. Like, it's his voice was crazy, and he always sounded like this live. It's really just Korn. I'm not even going to the website. I'm not doing it. But I believe you. Balls, what up, Uberism? Back again. Had it back on Wednesday. Went down on Thursday. Now it's back again. Thank God. I think it's good this time. The reason it went down yesterday was because of like a weird activation error on their end. Dude, his voice is just so iconic. So good. Okay, we watched. Yo, this. Oh my God, dude. Streams tomorrow. Fuck. You know what? Let's listen to this song real quick. Let's watch the music video. Job for a Cowboy. We talked about this the other day, actually. There's a lot of people, especially metalheads, that instead of listening to music with their ears, they listen to it with their eyes. Meaning they see a band name and they're like, oh, that's not metal. Or they see the band playing live and they're like, oh my God, they were wearing skinny jeans and didn't have long hair. They weren't wearing camo pants or Dickie shorts. That's not a metal band. They're like a metalcore, hardcore band. I don't like that. Job for a Cowboy, just based off of their name and the way they looked, a lot of old metalheads just wrote them off or would hate them. But they were a death metal band. Like, This shit was, when this song came out, it was so good. But it was, same thing happened to the Black Dahlia Murder. All these old metalheads at like Ozfest would just sit there and like flip off the Black Dahlia Murder because they didn't look metal enough. It's cringe, dude. They started the pipsqueak. But they saw this dude in tight jeans, his straight, like, scene kid hair, and they're just like, oh, no, this isn't metal. You mean YouTube premium or Pornhub premium? What are we, or Pornhub? Ooh, I don't know who Ass Jack is, but I can imagine based off of the name. YouTube? I don't know, but I have ad blocker. What up, Giving Tree? Yo, Giving Tree. We're almost done with TikTok, so I'll play some of my bands for you. I know I said we'd do that. No, that was good. That was good, Thrasher. Oh, Hank Green's metal band. Okay. That, oh my god, yeah. I can't believe they would treat him like that. That shit was so good. Yeah, there's just a lot of people that listen to music with their eyes and not their ears, you know? Every time there's a break, like, and you hear that big boom, that's literally an 808 kick drum, like you hear in trap music. I love it. Like what Young Skirt uses in his beats, 808s. A huge part of metal, like contemporary metal. I'll point it out next time. Dare to bomb. I'm gonna tell on you first. Yes, yeah, it's so cringe, Science. Yeah, yeah. But you know, you're a based individual who listens with his ears, you know. It's an innate bomb world out here. I'll eat you. Oh, there was one right there. Boom, that boom. That's literally an 808 kick drum. Those pig squeals, dude. I think they're the ones that kind of started doing that. They were the first time I heard it. Discord, just so I know exact, I pull up the exact one you're thinking of. Oh, dude, those little bell hits. Yeah, dude, that's such a good band. Such a good band. Mudvayne, another good metal band. A lot of metalheads didn't like them that much, though, but I loved Mudvayne back in the day. $1 you ever had. That's right, the bomb. Oh, Maylene and the Sons of Disaster. Yeah, yeah, I remember them. Yeah, I remember them. Dunsies. All right, here, let's pull that up real quick. Oh, we'll be done with TikToks here in a minute, I think. We've been doing a lot of TikToks. We didn't get through all of them that I want, but I do want to play some Dark and Darker here pretty soon. Thank you, DeBomb. Thank you. Thank you. What the hell's wrong with this YouTube page? Okay, here we go. Wow! They start doing the triplets along with the motorcycle. Oh god, is that the Dimebag Darrell fucking Confederate flag guitar? God damn, dude. I love Pantera, but... People, they'll always be like, it was heritage, not hate, but Vinnie Paul had a house in Vegas where he, like, literally had, like, Confederate flags all around his fucking house. I remember one time I actually got into an internet argument on Instagram with Dimebag Darrell's wife. I was like, they should burn that guitar. And she was like, it was heritage, not hate. And I was like, you don't know what you're talking about. Love Dimebag Darrell, though. He's a great guitar player. Yeah, that's literally that guitar. That flag, like, literally represents racism and slavery. And the upholding of it. They got that high helm. High helm. Oh, is that what these guys are doing? Are they okay, interesting. Nice Volk, let's go. Are there any other TikToks I wanted to look at, like, for sure? The bomb. I forgot to go back and look at that one TikTok. The Dark and Darker one. My bad. I know how to fight that thing. I'll teach you. I watched that TikTok. Follow us down. Follow us down. Follow us down. God damn, Cyber Stephanie, bro. That was great. Okay. Thank you for sharing. How to last
what
longer?
Are the things that you think
this
about?
Is Jasmine Rice Girl's podcast, the one that used to own Fan House.
To keep you from busted. To-do list, like the next. What are the things that you think about to keep you from busted? To-do list, like the next day.
Such thinking about work. Such a good
homework. Things that are going wrong in life that I gotta like focus on. You ever start looking at inanimate objects around
yes,
the room?
Yes.
I'm like, damn, I'm just concentrating that
doorknob.
On that doorknob.
Yep.
I have
wow.
set objects in the room placed to focus on.
Wow.
Yeah, because I want to give her just a couple extra more seconds, right?
Yeah, a few
seconds?
More at least.
Seconds? So I'm trying to hold it in and just because this is too good.
Wow.
Too good.
Have you ever looked at something and it didn't work? It just made you more turned on?
Like the light bulbs
and it looks
like
a... You're like, oh, no.
I have to do the opposite. I have to think about things so that I can nut.
Do you?
Ooh, that's rough. Oh, God. Get yourself a better guy. Jasmine.
Realize when guys are trying to focus on not combusting,
yeah, right.
you
Ouch.
Just see him like state like
Ouch.
I think the common suggestion is like, oh, think about your grandma.
No!
You know, that's weird. Just
Gross.
Like evacuating
Ew.
And then clenching.
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 Ew.
Like flexing your upper body helps because
Ew.
The blood goes elsewhere.
What, the fuck?
What are the things that you
grandma, no.
can't take that dick with your turn? In my own land, we can't merge. So with no hands you can learn. Let's see how much you can earn.
Okay, here, let's look at those real quick. Then you get an attraction. Yeah, then you're Jordan Peterson. You're literally Jordan Peterson at that point. Oh, nice, dude. Very cool. I like the Hawaiian shirt right there. That's a good one. That's probably my favorite, I think. That's very cool. I like this guy in front of him, too. Nice, dude. That's a cool weapon. It's like a flamethrower or something. Cool. Nice, dude. The medic, yeah. Okay, anything else? Anything important that we need to look at? This is actually really good.
People say no homo either. I think that's homophobic, man.
True. I've said this. No. We've had people say this in chat before, and I'm always like, that's, you don't say that.
No homo either. I think that's homophobic, man. I think if you say something that could be misconstrued as gay, instead of being like, you know, homo, I'm not gay, lean into it and suck a fucking dick already. Am I right? It's 2007 or whatever. A hole's a hole, man. We all feel like hot spaghetti in the dark. We've all been to prison or summer camp, right? You can't get a dude's butthole pregnant. No condoms tonight.
Let's go. Yeah, no, saying no homo is just very cringe and honestly homophobic. But okay, moving on. Let's see. Anything? This is all the flood stuff that we looked at. Mainly a bunch of flood stuff. I think we're done. I think this is it. Yeah, now it's like loading. Oh, and honestly, we looked at this stuff already. This now we're back at stuff that we already looked at. Oh, this guy right here. I was talking about this guy yesterday or the day before, and some of you are like, oh, I have no idea what you're talking about. This is the best TikTok live guy ever.
Reconfiguring. There's a glizzy jet on my six. Thank you for the call-outs, Commander. Awaiting next orders. Hoorah! Thank you for buying
down.
A subscription. This one's for you.
Miami Hitman style, nice. You hit it well.
Oh. We need more glizzies. I need more glizzies.
I need more glizzies. So good, dude. So good. Oh, I wish Chad was here to watch this with us.
What's
maybe
good,
I'll
guys?
Maybe
break-
yeah, oh, I'll save this for next time Chad's in chat. I'll save that one for then. Okay, let me just go through one more time. Was there anything else? And I think Zoop's gone We'll look at his TikToks another day.